Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. I've got a lot of requests for video on radio navigation numericals. So now before I talk about those topics, I need to talk about the basic topics like what is magnetic heading or what is true heading, what is variation, what is deviation and all that. So I'll cover all these points in this video. These terms are as it is very important when you go for your CPL, ATPL navigation exam, as you'll see a lot of direct questions on these. Like they'll just literally give you a heading, let's say a magnetic heading, and they'll ask you to find true heading. Believe me, there'll be a lot of questions like that. So let's dive into it. Let's start with what is true north. Now, true north is the direction on Earth that points towards the geographical North Pole. So the direction that is pointing towards this geographical North Pole will be my true north. Yeah, pretty self-explanatory. Now let's talk about what is magnetic north. So as most of you would know, our Earth acts like a magnet. In fact, we can say that our planet is actually a big bar magnet. It has magnetic field around it, and we can prove this by looking at a freely suspended magnetic needle. Now that magnetic needle, if suspended freely, will always align itself to some direction, right? We all have seen this. Now the direction in which the needle aligns itself to is towards the magnetic North Pole, which is over here. So that needle will always align itself to the magnetic North Pole. And the magnetic North Pole is the point on Earth where if you leave that magnetic needle freely, it would point vertically downwards. So if my magnetic needle is kept over here, freely suspended, so it will point towards the center of the Earth. And a point to note is that the geographical North Pole is not same as the magnetic North Pole. So on the Earth, we have two North Poles. One is our geographical North Pole and one is our magnetic North Pole. Both of these do not coincide. Okay, so two North Poles, magnetic and geographical North Poles. Let's now talk about what is heading. So in simplest words, your aircraft's heading is literally the direction in which its nose is pointing. And heading is always measured in clockwise direction from the north. So let's say this is the direction of our true north. And our aircraft is flying somewhere like this. Yeah, its nose is pointing this side. Now the heading of this aircraft will always be measured from the north and in the clockwise direction. So we'll see how many degrees it's making with the north. So let's say this is 070 degrees. Now this will be the heading of my aircraft. So my aircraft's heading is 070 degrees true. Why true? Because it's measured from the true north. Now similarly, let's say this arrow is pointing towards my magnetic north. Okay, so this will be my magnetic north pole. And if the aircraft is flying somewhere like this, its heading will be measured in the clockwise direction from the magnetic North Pole. So let's say this comes out to be 090 degrees. So this will be the heading of my aircraft with respect to the magnetic North Pole. So my aircraft's heading will be 090 degrees magnetic. Right, now let's plot both of these in one diagram. So this was my true north. This is degrees true. And this is my magnetic north. Since both of the magnetic and the true north poles are not coinciding, my red line is showing the direction towards the true north pole and the magenta line is showing the direction towards the magnetic north pole. Now if my aircraft was flying here, its magnetic heading will be measured from the magnetic north pole and its true heading will be measured from the true north pole. So let's say the magnetic heading was 070 degrees and the true heading was 050 degrees. Yeah, because the black angle is less than the yellow angle. So what we saw here is that there is an angle between the true and the magnetic north poles, which is also the difference between both of these headings, which is this angle. Now this angle is known as variation. Okay, so variation is the angle between the true North Pole and the magnetic North Pole. And this variation is very, very important in aviation. Why is it important? Because sometimes as pilots, we plot on charts. And when we are plotting on charts or maps, we are using the true north pole. But whenever we are flying, we take our heading with respect to the magnetic north pole. So it's very important for us to know what is the difference between the true north pole and the magnetic north pole. Now let's talk about variation in detail. So variation is the difference between the true and the magnetic north poles. So in this diagram, it's this angle, which is between the magnetic north pole, which is the blue arrow, and the true north pole, which is the green arrow. Now variation can be given to us with respect to east or west. If the variation is given in east, it means that the magnetic north is east of the true north. And if variation is given in west, it means that the magnetic north is west of true north. Okay, so let's say this is my true north. So this is degrees true north. And this is my magnetic north. When the magnetic north is east of the true north, the variation will be east. Okay, now similarly, if this was my true north and this was my magnetic north, here we see that our magnetic north is west of true north. Yeah, so the variation will be given in west. Okay, so I hope you understood what is variation east and what is variation west. Now let's look at some of the examples. So let's say this was true north. This is my magnetic north. And here we can see that the variation is west. So here it's given that variation is 5 degrees west. So the type of questions you can get is that you'll get an aircraft and they'll give you, let's say it's true heading. So the true heading is given to be 080 degrees. So if you know what is magnetic heading and what is true heading, you'll easily do it. So here what we have to do is to find the magnetic heading. We know that the magnetic heading is measured from the magnetic north pole, and the magnetic north pole is west of the true north pole. So we know the variation also. So what we'll do is we'll just add variation to 080 degrees. So it will be 080 plus 5 degrees, which is equal to 085 degrees. So this is the magnetic heading, and we were given the true heading. Okay, now let's say this was the true north and the magnetic north is over here, which is east of the true north. Here the variation is given to be 5 degrees east. Okay, our aircraft is flying like this and we are given the true heading. So the true heading is 100 degrees and we are supposed to find the magnetic heading. Now we know that the magnetic heading is measured from the magnetic north pole, which is east of the true north pole. And we'll use the variation to find the magnetic heading. So here the green angle was 100 degrees and we have 5 degrees of variation. So the purple angle will come out to be 100 minus 5 degrees, which is equal to 0905 degrees. So this is the magnetic heading. Okay, so these are the type of questions you'll get in the exam. They'll give you one of the headings and they'll ask you to find the other heading using variation. Or they'll give you both the headings and ask you to find the variation. So now there's this universal trick which everyone uses to solve these type of questions. And this trick goes something like this. What these mean is that whenever your variation is east, which is this example. Here the variation was east, right? So whenever the variation is east, your magnetic heading will be least. Least means less than the true heading. So here what we saw was that the purple angle, which is my magnetic heading, is less than the true heading, which is the green arrow. Yeah, my true heading was 100 degrees and the magnetic was 0905 degrees. So whenever you have variation east, you should know that your magnetic will be less than true. So you can easily subtract the variation from the true heading to get the magnetic heading. Similarly, whenever your variation is west, which was this example, here your magnetic is best. So it's saying that whenever the variation is west, your magnetic will be more than the true heading. So here the purple arrow was your magnetic heading and the black arrow was your true heading. Right? So the true heading was given to be 080 degrees and your magnetic heading came out to be 085 degrees, which is more than the true heading. So whenever you get a question for variation west, you should just add the variation to the true heading and you'll get the magnetic heading because magnetic is best. So now this is the trick which you should remember. So variation east, magnetic least, variation west, magnetic best. And what is variation? Variation is the angle which is between the true and the magnetic north poles. Perfect. So that was about our true and magnetic norths. Now let's talk about the compass north. So when we were talking about the magnetic north, I said that when you freely suspend a magnetic needle, it will always point towards the magnetic north pole, correct? But what we see is that this property of a magnetic needle is not true inside the aircraft. Now, since there are a lot of wires and cables inside an aircraft, there is additional magnetism that is induced due to these wires. So what happens is that the needle, instead of pointing towards the magnetic north pole, points towards a new direction, and we call it the compass north. So compass north is purely because of the magnetism induced by the aircraft's electrical wires and cables. Okay, so let's say this was the actual direction towards the magnetic north pole where the needle should have pointed. But instead of pointing towards the magnetic north pole, the needle points somewhere else. Let's say it's here. So this is my compass north. Because the compass needle is pointing towards a new direction which is not the magnetic north pole. And this compass north is also not fixed. The compass north can be here, it can be here, it can be here, it can be here, it can be anywhere. It depends on the aircraft's magnetism. So wherever the magnetism is pulling it, it'll go or point in that direction. So what we've seen till now is that only the true geographical north has a fixed position. The other north poles are not fixed. The magnetic north pole is not fixed as it moves around the true north. And similarly, the compass north is also not fixed. It moves according to the magnetism inside an aircraft. So wherever the magnetism will pull it, it'll go that side. Okay. And just like variation, here we have a term called deviation. So deviation is the angle between the magnetic north pole and the compass north pole. And just like variation, if the compass north is east of the magnetic north, deviation will be east. And if the compass north is west of the magnetic north, the deviation will be west. Okay, like we discussed variation, let's discuss deviation now. So let's say this was my magnetic north pole. And we have east deviation, so our compass north pole is over here, which is east of the magnetic north pole. This angle is deviation, which is given to be 5 degrees east. East because the compass north is east of the magnetic north. Let's say there's an aircraft over here. So the compass heading of this aircraft is, let's say, 40 degrees. But the magnetic heading of this aircraft will be 40 plus 5, which is 45 degrees magnetic. So what we saw is that whenever a deviation is east, our compass is least. Right? So compass heading is less than the magnetic heading. So deviation east, compass least. Similarly, if my magnetic north was over here, and the compass north was west of the magnetic north, let's say giving a deviation of 5 degrees west, and an aircraft is over here, so the magnetic heading will be this and the compass heading will be this. So if the magnetic heading was 050 degrees, the compass will be 050 plus 5 degrees of deviation, which is 055 degrees. Here what we can write is that deviation west, compass best. Because our compass heading was more than the magnetic heading. So here again we have these two tricks, deviation east, compass least, and deviation west compass best. Okay, so I hope you understood what is true north, what is magnetic north, what is compass north, and what is variation and what is deviation. Variation is between true and magnetic north, and deviation is between magnetic and the compass north. So now let's look at some of these questions. So the first one says that our compass heading is 100 degrees, deviation is 20 degrees west. We have to find the magnetic heading. The variation is given 4 degrees east and we don't have the true heading. So how can we solve these questions? First way is to plot everything, and the second way, which is a faster way, is to use the tricks we did earlier. So variation east magnetic least, variation west magnetic best, deviation east compass least, deviation west compass best. So first we'll solve by plotting. So we are given the compass heading. Let's say this is the compass north. So compass north, aircraft flying like this. So the compass heading is given to be 100 degrees and the deviation is west. Now deviation is the angle between the compass north and the magnetic north. So what deviation west means is that our compass north is west of the magnetic north. So west is this direction. That means our magnetic north will be somewhere over here. And the deviation is 20 degrees. So what will be my magnetic heading? It will be this angle, which is 100 minus 20. So it will be 80 degrees magnetic. So my magnetic heading comes out to be 80 degrees. Now I have variation east. So whenever I have variation east, my magnetic north is east of the true north. And east is this direction. So that means my true north will be somewhere over here. So that my variation is east and the magnetic north lies east of the true north, right? So we have 4 degrees variation. Now my true heading will be this. So what is this? This is 80 degrees magnetic plus 4 degrees of variation. So it will be 84 degrees. Okay, so this is how we do it by plotting. Now if I just use those two tricks, so we had deviation west, compass best, deviation east, compass least, and variation west, magnetic best, variation east, magnetic least. So here my deviation is 20 degrees west. West means my compass will be best. So my compass heading is 100 and it says compass best. That means my compass heading will be more than the magnetic heading. So I'll just subtract 20 degrees from 100. And I'll get the magnetic heading. Okay, next I have my variation, which is 4 degrees east. So variation east, magnetic least. That means my magnetic heading will be less than the true heading. So what I'll do is that I'll add the variation and get the true heading, which is 84 degrees. So I can do it by either ways. Either I plot all the north poles or I just use the tricks. For exam purposes, obviously the trick is faster. Next, let's look at this question. So here I have deviation east and variation west. So if I use the tricks, I have deviation east, compass least, and variation west, magnetic best. Okay, so first is deviation east, compass least. That means my compass is less than the magnetic. I have the magnetic heading 320 degrees. I have to find the compass heading. Compass heading will be less than the magnetic heading. So what I'll do is that I'll subtract 4 degrees from 320 degrees and I'll get 316 degrees. This is my compass heading, right? Next, I have variation west. Now what is variation west? It says magnetic best. So that means my magnetic will be more than the true. Now for the magnetic heading to be more than the true heading, I'll have to subtract the variation from it to get the true heading. So my true heading will come out to be 320 minus 2 degrees west, which is 318 degrees. Yeah, you see how fast this was? So deviation east, compass least, I found the compass heading, and variation west, magnetic best. Using this, I found my true heading. Okay, so now the third question. Here, I don't have my deviation or variation. I just have my compass, magnetic, and true heading. Here also my trick will work. So I'll just write the trick again. Deviation west, compass best, deviation east, compass least, variation west, magnetic best, variation east, magnetic least. So here, let's compare the magnetic heading and the compass heading. So my magnetic heading is more than the compass heading, correct? So my compass heading is least, which is this condition. Now what this means is that my deviation will be east. So I'll just write east over here first. And what is deviation? Deviation is the difference between the compass heading and the magnetic heading. So what is the difference between 20 and 50? It is 30 degrees. So my deviation is 30 degrees east. Similarly for variation, I'll compare my magnetic heading and my true heading. So here I see my true heading is more than the magnetic heading, which means that my magnetic is least. And whenever the magnetic is least, my variation is east. So again I'll write east over here. And variation is the difference between magnetic and the true headings, which is 50 minus 80. So that comes out to be 30 degrees east. Okay, this is also quite easy. In the last example, I'm given my deviation, variation, and only the true heading. Okay, so I'll use the tricks again. I have deviation east over here. So I'll just write the deviation east trick. Deviation east, compass least, and variation is also east. So the variation east trick is variation east, magnetic least. Okay, so since I have the true heading, I'll start from here this time. So here, variation east, magnetic least. That means my magnetic will be less than the true heading. True heading is 250, variation is 5 east. So I'll just subtract 5 from 250. My magnetic heading will come out to be 215 degrees. You understood what I did here? I saw that variation east gives my magnetic least. So I just subtracted the variation from the true heading and I got the magnetic heading, because magnetic heading is less than the true heading, which I saw from the trick. Yeah, now I have my magnetic heading and I have the deviation. I have to find the compass heading. So deviation east will give my compass least. Compass least means compass will be less than the magnetic heading. So my magnetic heading is 215 degrees. Compass heading will be 215 minus 2 degrees, which is the deviation. So it comes out to be 213 degrees compass. So I hope you understood all these terms. Believe me, if you know how to solve questions like these, you'll be very comfortable solving the exam questions. So before I start posting radio navigation videos, I'll post another very short video on what is track made good, what is track error, track required, drift, what happens with winds, how do we correct for winds, and all that. So I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.